The Indian election season is now louder than ever, and everyone is having to answer the same simple question. Who do you think is the right candidate to vote for a better India? But this answer, unfortunately, is not so simple for a lot of us. Every party has its own USP. From Modi, Kejriwal, Rahul Gandhi, from secularism, anti-corruption and economic growth, everything seems a necessity. But does any party quite fit the bill entirely? So with a ton of political parties competing for our attention, how do we then make the right choice for the next 5 years? To put things in the right perspective, a kid today in 5th standard will be in college before elections for the Lok Sabha happen again. But time is not the only face of this puzzle, unfortunately. Another major factor is the money. Lots and lots and lots of money that is involved. According to estimates, the amount our political parties are spending is more than what the last US presidential elections cost. This whopping 10,000 crores is almost the salary of an average hardworking Indian for 2,50,000 years. Even if we ignore the source of so much money, we cannot deny the simple fact that wherever this money is coming from, it can be used in a lot of ways to alter the way we think and we decide. From television to newspapers to social media to advertising on billboards or otherwise, one question that we all need to ask is, are these factors clouding our judgment? Well, here's one way we could bypass these clouds. Let's look at the two most prominent players this election, Arvind Kejriwal and Narendra Modi, and let's map out the worst fears they're often linked with that we keep hearing about in the media. Kejriwal and Aam Aadmi Party, for example, is believed to be inexperienced, the B-team of the Congress, has a one-point agenda of anti-corruption, and tends to run away from responsibility. Modi and BJP, on the other hand, is believed to be responsible for communal riots, provides unfair help to big corporations, being soft on corruption, and so on. Both candidates might also have a lot of positives. They might have done a lot of good work as well, and they might continue to do so in the future. But let's just try and strictly analyze what's the worst thing that could happen. What if our worst predictions come true? Then we would be in for a nasty future. Let's look at all possible scenarios that could happen in the future. When faced with uncertainty, I guess, about such an important decision, it's a good idea to analyze all possible consequences and their impact on the lives of 1.2 billion Indians. Let's analyze if our worst fears are then true or not. If you vote for Kejriwal and he comes to power and the fears are all false, that's great. We'll have a corruption-free government, we'll have all the policies and decisions made by the people and all that fancy stuff that they've been promising. Now if you vote for Modi and he comes to power and all the fears are false too, even better, we'll have an increased industrial growth, higher GDP and a brighter future for India. Amazing. Let's analyze the harshest way we can. Let's see if you vote for Kejriwal, he comes to power and our worst fears turn out to be true. What problems can we have? We will have an inexperienced government with chaotic decision making that brings administration to the streets. With anti-corruption as the sole agenda, corruption might reduce, but important factors like economic development will take a backseat. If it does become the B-team of the Congress, as we've seen in the last 10 years, the overall development will be stagnant, and if he runs away from power, we might have elections sooner and have a lack in governance, which would cost us quite some money. Sounds pretty bad to me. But since we granted this extreme to Kejriwal, it's only fair that we grant the extreme to Modi too. With Modi's Hindu Nationalist Party BJP, communal tension and rioting could well be the norm across the country. The Hindu-Muslim riots, which we've seen only on the television, will happen in your town, right outside your doorstep. With crony capitalism, Modi's approach to provide unfair help to few big corporations will drag small businesses out of the market. Even though the GDP and industrial growth might occur, the rich will become richer and the poor will be dragged further down poverty. With Modi's soft stand on corruption, India's recent history of scams might just get bigger. So be it Kejriwal or Modi, if our worst fears come out to be true after the general elections, we might take decades recovering from them. Which risks do you think you can afford to take? feel free to disagree with my observations. But if you agree with my method, make your own chart, list out your concerns, and weigh your options wisely. To gain an upper hand this election season and to do our bit responsibly, let us then rethink our political stand. Rely on credible sources which are informative but not opinionated. Put our stand to test and have issue-based discussions with friends and family. And let us most importantly go out to vote. Our future is in our hands today, and our country needs a well-thought and honest vote more than ever. Jai Hind. This video is not funded by any political parties, and the sole purpose of this channel is social awareness and not propaganda of any sort. If you like the concept, share it with your friends and family. Thank you for watching.